يذكرنا بالحدث الأعظم. واسمح لي أن آخذ قبسا من نور المبعوث الأكرم.
علمنا
في الهجرة درسا يهدينا لطريق أقوم.
أقبل يا شهر محرم وابدأ من دار ابن الأرقم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده وعلى آله وأصحابه الصدق وصفا. والحمد لله رب العالمين يا رب أصلح فساد قلوبنا وأنزع الغل والحسد من قلوبنا رب العالمين. اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا وأنت تجعل الحسن سهلا إذا شئت. رب يسر ولا تعسر وتمم بالخير وبك نستعين يا فتاح يا فتاح يا فتاح. وببركة إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأنزله المقعد المقرب عندك. صلاة وسلام عليك يا رسول الله، صلاة وسلام عليك يا حبيب الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا شفيع المذنبين. الحمد لله. To my most respected ulama ikram, respected Hufaz brothers, and to the listeners of ITV, I greet you with the universal greeting of Islam, a greeting of peace, a greeting of love, a greeting of generosity, which is Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, once again we witness Yawm al-Jum'ah, Yawm al-Surur, Yawm al-Fallah, Yawm al-Najah, a day where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored for us to be a day of Eid, day in and day out. And with that, we would like to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for granting us this opportunity to come and witness this Yawm al-Jum'ah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our du'as. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for all of us. Any type of problem, Allah grant us the tawfiq, and may Allah accept all our jum'ahs, inshallah. It is my pleasure to also thank the trustees of the Masjid of Uthman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them for granting us this opportunity. I'm coming all the way from Durban. I'm just here in Pretoria, inshallah, for some few programs. And I was honored to be called and come and share my discourse here in this Masjid. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless the trustees. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all the musallis and all the Muslims throughout the globe, inshallah. Ameen, thumma ameen. Alhamdulillah, brother in Islam, we all know that the days of Jum'ah, it is the day where we get to teach one another. It is the days where we get to see the problems that we are facing within the Ummah of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we come and address those problems, and we try, inshallah, and we change day in and day out, inshallah. And that is why they say in English, the only constant thing is life is change. Meaning that if you are a Muslim, you have to try by all means to change. If you don't change, then you have a problem. So with this, Jum'ahs are given for us to make sure that we change, inshallah, for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it easy for all of us. And that way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant us the maqam for all our du'as to be accepted, inshallah. Ameen. Say ameen. My topic for discussion today is nothing new, but it's just about the three traps of shaitan. The topic for discussion today, yes, there are four and there are many more traps of shaitan, but due to time, inshallah, we'll just share the three traps of shaitan in the Holy Quran, where you and I, that shaitan was being chased from Jahannam, because why? He became takabbur, he became haughty, and that is why anyone who has this takabbur in him, anyone who has this hotness in him, that point in time, if you feel like that, then you must know that you have shaitan in you. So what you need to do is you need to calm down, either drink water or try and move the, you know, in the place that you are sitting, and try and find another place which will be good for you to relax, inshallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, بَعْدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ In the surah, the first trap of shaitan that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us is وَلَا أُضِلَّنَّهُمْ وَلَا أُضِلَّنَّهُمْ. Shaitan, he promised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala these traps, that because you are now chasing me away from Jannah, what I need to do now, I need to have followers. You and I know those, you know, who have, you know, Facebook and WhatsApp, social media. Everybody has followers, right? Even within not social media. But somebody somewhere somehow follows you. Either your child, either your wife, either your friend or anyone. But somebody somewhere somehow will have to follow, even if it's a shadow. But even Shaitan promised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, Ya Allah, now that you are throwing me out, because why? He is mardood, he is rejected, Shaitan is rejected right up until, you know, eternity, right up until even, you know, the day of Qiyamah, he will still be rejected. So what he did is, he planned that he saw by Allah that I will make sure that I have my followers with me. I will make sure that when I go to Jahannam, at least, you know, I need to have followers that are going to go with me to Jahannam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all, inshallah. And one of those shaitan, he says that وَلَا أُضِلَّنَّهُمْ, I am going to misguide them. And you and I know, every after the month of Ramadan, you know, on the day of Eid, it is stated, you know, that shaitan cries. Just on the day of Eid, after the month of Ramadan, shaitan cries and he becomes angry. And the small shaitan, they come and ask him, you know, because he's dead Amir, that why are you crying, O shaitan, O our Amir, why are you angry today? It's a day of Eid. He says, the reason why I'm angry today is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven the ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this whole month of Ramadan. That is why I'm angry today. And shaitan tells the small shaitans, he says, from today, give them more of entertainments. From today, make sure that you distract them from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is why A'imma says, مَنْ يَهَدِهِ اللَّهِ فَلَا مُضِلَّ لَهُ وَمَنْ يُضْلِلُهُ فَلَا هَدِيَ لَهُ. So be very careful. For those who don't understand the Arabic, go sit for classes and understand Lughatul Arabiya, because it is important for all of us. What happens is, Shaytan tells Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that وَلَا أُضِلَّ لَهُمْ, I am going to misguide them. And how is happening? How does Shaitan misguide us in today's time? Today is Yawmul Jumu'ah. I said this last week in Durban, that, you know, today is Yawmul Jumu'ah, but some of the Muslims, a'udhu billahi min dhalik, they have two Jumu'ahs on the day of Friday. The Jumu'ah, yeah, in the Masjids, and the other Jumu'ah is within the clubs. That's the Jumu'ah that we have nowadays. And what happens in the clubs, a'udhu billahi min dhalik, ajeeb. You find that Muslims, male and female, are the ones who are telling the kuffar, don't worry my friends, today everything here is on me. A'udhu billahi min dhalik. A Muslim telling kuffars that today in this shebeen, in this club, everything is on me. I am going to buy your alcohol. I am going to make sure that I am going to put, you know, the rents in the jukebox so that we dance more the whole night. Muslims today. And that is why Shaitan says, وَلَا أُضِلَّنَّهُمْ, I am going to misguide you, so that if I misguide one, the other one will misguide another one, another one will misguide another one. Slowly, the ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam turns away from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's the first trap of Shaitan, where he said, وَلَا أُضِلَّنَّهُمْ, I am going to misguide. Look at the ummah today. Look at what's happening within us today. A lot of us are misguided. A lot of us don't want to follow Quran and Hadith. We want to compromise. Even if the business is beyond Quran and Hadith, we want to say, no, next time, inshallah. Allah will understand, man. A'udhu billahi min dhalik. This is the situation that we find ourselves to. Why? Because Shaitan told the small Shaitan that from today, after the month of Ramadan, now that they are fresh, now that the ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is forgiven, now that they are clean, try and give them more entertainment. Try and distract them away from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That way they are going to be able to be my chamcha, they say in Urdu. They are going to be able to be my followers. And that is why you find that a lot of Muslims today, they are the followers of Shaitan, not the followers of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You look at the Jummahs in today's time. How many of the Muslims come for Jummah? they see the time, oh now I think the muadhin, you know, or the imam is going to stand up for khutbah, then only I must go into the masjid. Yet the brother doesn't understand Arabic. He doesn't even understand the meaning of Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. The English lecture is there for you, Habib, for you to change. But because you are haughty, you have this takabbur in you, you have this shaitanic, you know, actions in you, you don't want to come for English lectures because you don't want to be burnt out because of Quran and Hadith. And you want to only come when the muadhin want to stand up for salah or either for khutbah because you just want to kill time. A'udhu billahi min dhalik. And the second trap of shaitan, Allah, shaitan promised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that وَلَأُمَنِّيَنَّهُمْ. The reason why I'm taking a bit faster is because of time. The second one is وَلَأُمَنِّيَنَّهُمْ. I am going to cause amongst them false desires. Meaning that everything they see, everything they desire for, it has to be faulty. It has to be faulty. It has to be something against from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything that they look, they see, they want to walk on top, they want to touch, they want to speak about, they want to do, it has to have some faulty in it so that they can be under my flag into Jahannam. And shaitan makes sure in today's time. How are we faulty in today's time? How do we follow false desires? And you look at the, you know, the biggest example is there are two ulama in today's time. The ulama that sits in front of, you know, the ma'allim and teaches them and they become ulama. And the other ulama are the ones who learn from Mufti, Allama, Google. And those who learn, they don't even know who's behind that, you know, the page. They are sitting and learning and make sure that they're taking the daras from these, you know, websites which we don't even know whether they are Islamic or un-Islamic. Then what happens? Because why these ulama of thoughts are from Mufti Google and other ulama and sat down and learn from the shuyukh, from the a'imma, from the imams. What happens when they come into public and they start fighting? False desires, Habibi. You are looking at something else, whereas Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught us how to do things according within the sunnah of the Holy Four Prophets sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And what happens is, I am going to cause amongst them to have or to feel or to do anything which have false desires in today's time. And what happens? Look at the children nowadays. They disrespect their parents. What do they do? In Durban, it's a taboo. What happens is you find that in Durban, you know, you find that, you know, when the two couples get married, what do? They discuss it more, my husband or my wife, you know, we are married now. Let us chuck our mother and our father into all the houses. We're tired of them. They're gonna waste our time. They won't give us, you know, the love. You know, we need the romance, we need the new love. So let us throw them away from when we go leave them there in those old ages. We don't even know who's looking after them, who is giving them food, what food they eat. We don't care about them because of false desires, Habibi. Yet Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, you know, Al Jannatu tahta aqdamil ummahat, that Jannah lies under the feet of your parents. How is it that you are taking your Jannah and you're putting it away of all the old house? How are you gonna get the Jannah when you're throwing it away? And you find it in today's time, you find that a lot of people are falling from the traps of shaitan. Because why? We don't understand. Imam Shafi alayhi rahmah, he says, تَزَوَّدُوا مِنَ الدُّنْيَا فَإِنَّكَ لَا تَدْرِي إِذَا جَنَّ اللَّيْلِ هَلْ تَعِيشُ إِلَى الْفَجْرِ فَكَمْ مِنْ صَحِيحٍ مَاتَ مِنْ غَيْرِ عِلَّةٍ وَكَمْ مِنْ سَقِيمٍ عَاشَ حِينَ مِنَ الدَّهْرِ. Imam Shafi alayhi rahmah, he says, you know, you are fading away from this dunya, but you do not know. A lot of us don't understand. How many of us, when we grew up without beards, now we have beards. We don't understand that the more we have beard, it becomes black and it becomes white. It means it's the more we come nearer to our graves. But a lot of us don't understand. وَكَمْ مِنْ صَحِيحٍ مَاتَ مِنْ غَيْرِ عِلَّةٍ. How many were those who are healthy and they died without any reason? Imam Shafi says that. How many? They were healthy. You go to the doctor, you ask the doctor, my doctor, what happened to this patient? And the doctor will tell you, I don't know. The machines, everything's right. There's nothing wrong with this brother. He just died. وَكَمْ مِنْ سَقِيمٍ عَاشَ حِينَ مِنَ الدَّهْرِ. And how many were those who were sick, but they lived for long? You hear in the community that so-and-so is sick, make dua for him. So-and-so is sick, make dua for him. Next month, next year, after next year, the person we've been saying is sick, is sick, is sick. For how many years we've been saying sick, but he's still alive? Imam Shafi tells us. Imam Ash-Shafi'i tells us that we should be very, very careful in today's time. And the last trap of Shaitan, Shaitan says, you know, when he promised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he says, وَلَأَأْمُرَنَّهُمْ أَن يُغَيْرَ خَلَقَ اللَّهِ. It's very dangerous. That I am going to cause amongst them to change your creation, خَلَقَ اللَّهِ, a creation created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shaitan will put within us to change ourselves. What's happening in today's time? You know, I've seen one brother using, you know, a light brown, you know, a shoe polish on his face, light brown. And you ask the brother, why are you doing this? He says, I want to look a bit whiter. A'udhu billahi min dhalik. Shaitan making sure that he's gonna make us to change. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has make you to look like me. So why is it that you want to look more whiter? Because why Allah says, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created the best. You are an African and you look like this. Stay like that, Habib. Because why Allah says, أَنْتَ, you know, فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. You are an Indian, you look a bit whiter. Stay like that. You are white, you look a bit whiter. Stay like who you are, because Allah says, "Fi ahsan taqwim." So how is it that in today's time we want to change ourselves? Our sisters today, what do? They cut off all these things off. And what do? They go within the shops and they go by those black pencils and they rearrange themselves, Habib. When Allah says, "Fi ahsani taqweem," look at the sisters, Muslim sisters, a'udhu billahi min dhalik. One of the sisters even told her in the mall, "My sister, you are disturbing our iman." She asked why. He says, "You know, your face, you know, you have more than, you know, eight colors within your face. Why? You have purple here, you have pink here, you have blue here, you have black here, you have brownish. What's happening within you, sister?" And some of the sisters will tell you that, you know, "I can't even make wudu. Because once I make wudu, everything will fall off. A'udhu billahi min dhalik. وَلَأَأْمُرَنَّهُمْ أَن يُغَيْرَ خَلَقَ اللَّهِ." Shaitan told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I am going to make sure that they change their creation. And especially as within us as Africans, a lot of us want to change us. We want to become like whites. We want to become like white people. The way we speak, we just want to become like white people. We no more want to speak Setswana. We don't more want to speak Sesotho. We don't want to speak Zulu. We don't want to speak, you know, Ndebele. All these languages, we are chucking it off. Yet these people, they don't have time with us, Habibi. They don't have, you know, a jalsa in a year that, you know, these Africans, you know, in this country, they want to look like us. They want to become like us. So let us give them a jalsa and certificates. Congratulations. No, my brother. But why is it that you as an African, you want to change yourself? Look at Bilal al-Habashi. Radiallahu ta'ala anhu arda. A sahabi. What happened to him? So much so that even Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he passed on, he came to Bilal al-Habashi, a person that loved himself, because man arifa nafsahu arifa Allah. Anybody who knows himself, anybody who identifies himself, he is able to identify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bilal al-Habashi radiallahu ta'ala anhu arda, that even Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to visit him in his dream, that, "Oh Bilal, what happened to you? What happened to you? Why are you no more visiting me?" A person that loved himself, a person that even, you know, within the narration it is stated that, you know, some of us, he was even more blacker than you and I. But he did not feel shy. He did not look within the market to go look where this clear, you know, this thing which they sell within the market to change your color. Bilal al-Habashi did not do that. He only feared Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He understood that when Shaitan says, وَلَأَأْمُرَنَّهُمْ أَن يُغَيْرَ خَلَقَ اللَّهِ, is because those people that falls under the traps of Shaitan are going to raise up among Shaitan the day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَ يَقُومُ الرُّوحُ الملائكة الصفة لا يتكلمون إلا من أذن له الرحمن وقال صواب. The day when everybody shall be standing on the safs, even if you are white, even if you are an Indian, even if you are an African, even if you are an Arab, even if you are who you are, my brother, the day when everybody shall be standing in the saf of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لا يتكلمون إلا من أذن له الرحمن وقال صواب. Nobody shall speak except whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him the permission to speak. And that time Allah will be asking, لمن الملك اليوم? Who is the boss now? Who got guts now? Who can say that I'm coming from Virgin Active? myself. I'm macho. I've got the guts. I can stand in front of Allah and challenge you, Allah. Nobody shall speak. Waqala sahaba. Nobody shall speak except that which is good. What are we going to tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? My brothers in Islam, this is a time where you and I need to identify yourself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made us to live in South Africa for one reason. Indians are in South Africa, Africans are in South Africa, Arabs are in South Africa. It is a rainbow nation, not for racial purposes, but for us to understand that it is for us to understand the verse of the Holy Quran when Allah says, لِكُلِّ جَعَلْنَا مِنْكُمْ شِرْعَةً وَمِنْهَاجًا. For us to understand two things in South Africa. One, it is the Sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Minhaj, our way of living. A lot of us, we live differently. We have different cultures. So what we need to do now in order for Islam to rise in South Africa is exchange your cultures. Teach one another our cultures, intermingling, marry one another. Otherwise, wallahi, we'll never ever be successful as Muslims in South Africa. We're gonna talk and talk and talk, but the success from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never come unless we understand the importance of لِكُلِّ جَعَلْنَا مِنْكُمْ شِرْعَةً وَمِنْهَاجًا. You are a Mutwana, go understand your culture. Go teach your people about culture in Islam. Don't purify Islam with culture, but try and purify your culture with Islam. Like what we're doing in KZN, subhanAllah. You know, once I was wearing this Zulu thing. I don't know if some of you'll know it. It's called in Zulu Umqele. You know, this thing with Zulu is worn by Zulus. So I was, you know, going down with the left. So one Zulu guy, brother, he says, my brother, you know, I did not know that Zulus are allowed to become Muslims. I did not tell him nothing. I was just wearing, because why? Even fil libas, there is da'wah, habibi. But if you are going to be an African and you always wearing like an Indian, you're an African, you are always wearing like an Arab, I don't say don't wear like them, habibi. Don't misinterpret me and go sit within your houses or your businesses and backbite on me and misinterpret me. Get me and get my point right. I don't say don't wear any other thing, but sometimes give your culture a space so that people can understand Islam. If you are a Motswana, try and come up with Nasheed, which is in Setswana. Try and come up with a Tawheed, which will identify the real culture of Setswana. If you are a Zulu, try and identify for purposes like in KwaZulu-Natal, subhanAllah, 85%, we did research, 85% of Zulu culture is within Islam. Like they're gonna tell you that according to Zulu culture, proper Zulus, nowadays we have two types of Zulus. One Zulu, Asian Zulu, who follows, you know, a lot of them about Islam, and some of them to this time, they don't understand nothing. So in Zulu, in proper Zulu, you're not allowed to eat with this left hand. You're allowed to eat with the right hand. That is why in Zulu they call it isandla sokudla, right? To those who know Zulu. And the other thing is within the Zulu culture, you are allowed that when you eat, you'll have to eat in one big, you know, platter, or maybe one big bowl. Isn't that the Sunnah, Habib? And the Zulu randolphs, these houses, it's called ukukastanaza in Zulu, meaning that's where you go bow down and you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what do they do to this time? They don't go. What do they do? They only go to churches. They don't understand their culture and Islam. So this is how we identify culture and trying to put Islam in so that people cannot chase us away. Wallahi, a lot of us as Africans, we have been thrown out by our nation. I repeat again, we have been thrown out by a nation. Why? They say you look like an Arab, you act like an Arab, you talk like an Arab, you don't talk like us, Habib. You no more speak Zulu in our house. It's all English. We don't know Zulu. But what we need to do, this is the time, Habibi. We need to unite. Leave the sting of color. Leave the sting of everything. But understand the importance of our color that you and I understand or share. It is Kalima La Ilaha Illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And to follow the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That way we'll be successful Muslims, inshallah. And that way we'll try, and even in South Africa we'll be try and become a proper Muslims. Otherwise, we're all getting it all wrong. Let us come with new strategic plans to see how we can come up with new da'wah. Subhanallah, I'm there in Durban, and I can see on Facebook some of the brothers are here in town and giving, you know, da'wah. Walking with their feet, Habibi, the Sunnah of Rasulullah, and support them. We only see a few. What about other brothers? Let us support them, brothers in Islam. If you don't want to support them where they are, start up something where you are at your own house so that Islam can rise for the pledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all, inshallah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for all of us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the tawfiq and hidayah to act upon what I've said. If there's something wrong I've said, it's from shaitan. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive me. But if there's something good I said, it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Please take it and don't leave it, my brother. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite us all as Muslims. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for all of us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the tawfiq and hidayah to act upon Quran and Hadith. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for all of us to be jannatis, inshallah. Say ameen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless each and everyone. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
ذكرنا بالحدث الأعظم واسمح لي أن آخذ قبسا من نور المبعوث الأكرم. علمنا في الهجرة درسا يهدينا لطريق أقوم. أقبل يا